Model rectifier sent over the 1/35th scale HobbyBoss M706 Commando armored car in Vietnam livery. This is a cool looking vehicle, so I asked him to send it over. I build it up. It's a mix between a tank and a car, obviously, with the giant treads, an all-wheel drive truck with a cool little turret on the top. There is no figure. That's just on the box art. There's also not a helicopter or a fence, and it's not also placed in Vietnam. They don't have Vietnam in the box or anything. So, just a little inside joke. But yeah, it's a cool looking vehicle. I'm going to start looking at all the parts. We're going to get this bad boy built up. Even though it's 1/35th scale, it does build into a nice size vehicle, 1/35th being the most standard size for land military models. The turret has a very nice cast texture to it. You can see where all the different hatches are. This does have a full interior, and it does look pretty cool. You can see the bottom of the hull, nice and smooth to deflect ordnance and allow it to scrape and scratch its way across the terrain. We've got the interior parts here. It's got the control panels, steering wheels, driver's seat, different mechanisms. We're going to find out what all those are as we go through and build it. I will be building the interior, but I won't be detailing it. We got a nice fret here full of hatches, access points. All these can be mounted open. We got a nice, possibly a bustle rack for the turret. We'll see, that's molded nicely there. Well parts, I like how if you need to put a handle on it, they do have little holes to actually place it in so that you're not just guessing and trying to get it glued. We got some duplicated trees. We got wheels. Numerous little handles molded very nicely. Small photo etched grab handles and parts. We've got accessory jerry cans. More handles, looks like some lighting. You get two identical trees of those. We've got two more trees left. The another set of wheels. More hatches, even have spring detail on the hatches. More grab handles. We've got our turret. Small ringlets to be mounted, probably for lifting the turret, I'm just gonna guess. Another fuel can, lots of stuff for the spare parts box. Looks like a grill here, another hatch, handles for the jerry cans, those wheels again, and one more with the driveline and suspension. So it's not a giant kit, but there are a good amount of parts to it to make it a fun build. Quite detailed. You got a machine gun here, molded very well. How they got that all in a one-piece mold, I don't know. We got a shovel there. Gearboxes, nice leaf spring detail. We've got an axe. We've got a tanker's tool, pry bar. Let's go to the other side of the table, see what else we've got in the box besides gray plastic. We've got all the clear parts molded on their own trees. We've got, let me get this little part out here. It's quite small. Little piece of real chain. Very nice looking. We'll get that mounted up wherever they decide it goes on the vehicle. We've got a little bit of photo etch. Beautiful screens for the front. I could have used these on that Italeri rally car build. Nice little set of photo etch screens so that they look realistic and they aren't all too big. We got a set of four rubber tires. Directional tread. Make sure you get them on the right way. We can sand and dust these up to look like they've been used at least once. Very nice. I don't see a brand name on the outside, which doesn't matter. It's mil spec. Nice set of decals on there. We've got the two different options. You can build this vehicle with two different sets of decals. MP decals, Blind Faith, American Stars, Military Police logos, unit numbers, all on the water slides, and they let you see the two versions. We'll look at those really quick. We've got the ones with just the stars and the Blind Faith emblem. And then we've got the cool one with those huge MP emblems. Kind of digging that one. More like an urban patrol. So I'm going to get to building mine, and I will be right back. Takes about 30 minutes to do the interior at the bottom of the hull. You can see all the lovely detail on there. Like I said, I won't be highlighting mine. I don't display them with the hatches open or anything. So these are just quick reviews. Get them painted, get them detailed, let you see what goes into the kit so you can see how lovely that interior looks. Pedals, fire extinguishers, control boxes, tiny little levers, transmission, air intakes, all kinds of stuff on the inside. You can go nuts. A super detailing and everything on there. Little seats in there. I mean, everything. They thought of everything on that interior. On the outer hull, before you join them, they want you to drill some holes. They are marked from the bottom and on the outside where they should be drilled. You have to open up that little hole there, that little hole there, and some holes underneath the hatches for grab handles and I assume steps. And you can see where they mold those in, and you'll just drill into those so that you can mount your parts. And that's as simple as it is. That's as lovely as the interior looks. And I am ready to already join the upper and lower hulls and start working on the suspension. Getting to this point in the sub-assemblies is about 3 hours, and that's because you really assemble the entire vehicle. If you're not going to do the interior separately, you really assemble the entire vehicle. You get your turret done, and you get your main hull done here. Look how beautiful and detailed this is. Look at all the fine little handles and parts with their own little mounting locations. Absolutely beautiful. Now, this is a solid color vehicle in Vietnam, so we can get this all painted up. I also discovered if you want to do the interior and you want it to show through all these hatches and access points that they provide, which is why they provide the interior, because it's very nice looking and they give a ton of access points, back doors and everything, you can join the main hull and the lower hull at the end of the build after you've painted them all. You won't have very big seams. You can hide them quite well with detailing, so feel free to do that. Now, I'm just gonna have it as a shelf display model with all the hatches closed and everything, so I went ahead and built the entire sub-assembly, and it is absolutely beautiful. We got our suspension underneath, all our grab handles, and there are places to grab the model and work on it without snapping parts off. I did leave some of the finer parts off because I wanted to get the more detail in there. But I mean, look at that hatch. That will open in two pieces with the handles if you want to build it as such with the interior displayed. As you can see, I've got the windows in place on mine. And what I'm gonna, if you're going to be doing the interior, don't do that, because as you can see through here, you can see through those windows and you'll see detail on the inside. So you don't want to attach them, but what I did was I attached them because I'm going to spray the whole vehicle, weather it, and then I will go in and highlight each window with a technique and tint it so that it looks like it's closed on a closed interior. And you'll be able to see how I do that in the video, but otherwise we have an excellent looking kit that fits together so nice. You're not seeing any giant seams. There's very detailed parts, but everything isn't so small that it gets completely ripped off and destroyed if you try to handle the model, which is nice to have. The turret is a little piece of work itself. We got our two machine guns there. We got a large amount of viewing prisms, 8 of them total. We got little lifting eyelets so they can pull the turret off for maintenance. Those glue into place with little locating holes all built in and everything. So very, very nice piece of work. And again, here's another hatch that you could mount completely open and view the interior and down inside that beautiful armored vehicle. The wheels are a nice piece of work. Those tires are soft rubber, so I knew I could glue the wheels together and paint them on their trees and then slip them on. The photo etch, of course, will get painted on its own and then attached onto those nice little guards for the headlights. We'll get those in there, but then I can reach in there and detail the headlights. The headlights are clear pieces. You could mask off, but I'll show you how I'm gonna do that, and it's gonna look nice. I did decide to assemble 2 extra fuel tanks. I wanna place those on the vehicle. The tow hook is made from clear plastic. That will attach to the chain we showed in the beginning. We got our antenna here, which I can paint and attach. And we've got our tools. And I think I'm gonna paint the machine gun as well, and maybe just lay it on the top of the deck like they had brought it on to be attached later. I don't know. I'll put that on, maybe I won't. We got the shovel, we've got our axe, we've got our entrenching tool, our pickaxe right there. Those will all be mounted on the back cargo area back here, but I want to get them painted up separate and then attach them later. We got the mirrors. Those mirrors mount right there on either side. They're very delicate, but they do go together nicely. It's a thin rod, But the mirror glass itself has a large locating hole and it pushes in. You won't have any issues with that. I'm going to paint it and then install a reflective surface on there just before I put them into their mounting holes. So that is it. I'm going to get everything over to paint. You can see how I'm going to pre-shade the model and then get some green on it. And then we're going to do some hand detailing to bring out a little bit of shadow and light and weather it, since it is a monotone, just like the German tank that I built out of plain gray and made it look pretty nice in that one color. We'll see you over in the painting section right now. That's how super duper easy it is to weather and have fun with a monochromatic vehicle. You can take a look at that turret where I did the green dry brushing on the top. Looks sharp on there. Also, you can see how nice those windows look. They've got that thick blue-green tint that they would with the armored glass, the thicker glass for prisms and sight lines, where it's much thicker than standard glass so that it's more impact and bullet resistant. You can see the vehicle itself, lightly Vietnam earth tones underneath, not completely destroyed. It is an MP vehicle. Also, don't have your weathering be exactly the same on the left as it is on the right of a vehicle. Look at your real car. Some sides are rusted out more on one side gets more dirty. It all depends. Usually the shoulder side is more dirty than the driver's side on a vehicle. So, and you can kind of replicate that with military vehicles or just build it as you see fit. So we got our varied green on the top. I did a little bit of dust on the top, but the way this vehicle is shaped with that wedge, it's going to keep down a lot of things. It's going to kick up dust around the back, so dirty up the back, and it's going to kick up dust in the front as they go down and around and follow other vehicles. But you're not going to get a ton on the top as far as I, you know, from knowing off-road vehicles and knowing tanks and stuff. They're just not going to get as filthy on the top as they do on the bottom half, especially when it's that delta V shape. It's going to attract more on the bottom. We got the wheels and tires gummed up. The rubber tires flex in real life, so you'll get dust and dirt on them. You make sure your treads are clean, because this surface for an MP is going to be in the city a lot. That's going to get rubbed clean by the road. The fuel tanks, the one bolted to the vehicle, I dirtied up as if it's always back there. These are just going to be kind of laid up here, so I want them to look like they just grabbed them out of the supply closet or the fuel dump and they tossed them on just for their day's patrols. We got the mirrors here. See how nice that Molotov finish is on there? We'll glue that in place. For all the little parts at the end, I'll glue on with dollar store super glue, and we'll put the tools in here. The pickaxe, its handle, the axe, and the shovel. I don't know if I'll put the machine gun on. I still haven't decided. I could lay it anywhere up here, just if they wanted to bring it along, or if they're getting ready to mount it up on the turret somewhere. Who knows? We can always make up our own story for it. And then lastly, just before I'm done, I will glue in the little photo-etched windows, or the little photo-etched screens. You can see that I got them painted up earlier with the same green, and we'll just glue those into place. They're beautiful, thin, and look awesome. So when I come back, we'll have that final. Well, there we have it, my very first HobbyBoss 1/35th scale kit, the M706 Commando armored car in Vietnam. Beautiful looking little model, lots of detail for something so small. We even got our little chain on there. I applied a brown wash in there and it kind of froze it solid hanging down, so that actually works out well. Love those little photo etch grills for the headlights on it. This was an MP vehicle. Military police, I thought it was so cool looking. Yes, I did end up putting the machine gun on, the fuel tanks extra on the top. Got the little antenna up there, decorated the tail lights, the headlights, the rear view mirrors with some Molotov chrome. And you can see that nice glass treatment I did that actually comes out a little shiny with that silver underneath it, gives you a little variation. And then we made sure to get that complete molding surround on the glass with the vehicle painted. And we didn't have to try to go in and mask anything and leave the windows clear or whatnot. Since I wasn't doing the interior, I didn't feel the need to, and it's very easy to just do the windows like that. I do them like that on armored vehicles quite a bit. On the more modern ones, I use a reddish tint when I mix them, so it looks like the more ruby prisms that they have in those. These ones were just thick glass, I think, so that's how I did them up, as very thick blue-green glass that you'd see when you were looking in from the outside. Very nice model, highly detailed. Can't believe that all these hatches open if you want to do the interior. It's insane. But you could put a figure in there, a Vietnamese figure. We got driver's area. You could really do this thing up and have a blast. Didn't have any issues with fit and finish. Everything went together nicely. As you see, I didn't use any filler at all. I glued them as they were, so this is how it comes out of the box. And then I detailed it and decorated it to my heart's content. Military vehicles are so much fun to detail and weather. You can see that green modulation on the top, where we have the lighter green, the faded green. Then wrapping around, we've got the Vietnamese earth down below, and the kit lends itself to very good detailing. The decals went on nicely. It is hard to get them over those hinges and everything, so they may not be lined up perfect, but they wouldn't be lined up perfect in the real world either. They'd have the logos kind of going over things and sprayed on quickly, so nothing is absolutely perfect in the military world. They're more worried about the general message of an MP vehicle getting out there, the unit numbers, than they are about it being perfectly pristine and sharp edge. Anyways, got the nice little machine guns on top of the turret. I painted those with a pavement color. We did that overall weathering and chipping on it, and I absolutely love it. It's a cute little vehicle. It's different. It looks tough. I'd like to buy one of these on surplus, take the turret off, put something else up there, and drive that around in the winter. I'd never get stuck. Make sure when you put the tires on, the chevrons face forward. They are directional tires in the real world, and you want those facing forward for best traction for the vehicle it was designed to. Once again, thanks for Model Rectifier Corporation for sending this over. This is my first HobbyBoss kit, but it won't be the last. Check out this monstrosity of a kit they sent over. The Puma CEV. Holy cow. That thing is gigantic. So eventually on the show, that absolute savage monster from the Israeli army will be assembled. But for right now, we got the M706 to get my feet wet with HobbyBoss, and I was very pleased. Highly detailed, lots of little parts on there, yet not complicated to put together or detail. Thanks again for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.